السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله حي على السلام حي على السلام حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
الحمد لله الحمد لله رب العالمين الصلاة والسلام على سيد الأنبياء والمرسلين أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله ربي زدني علما ربي زدني علما ربي زدني علما قال الله تعالى في القرآن الكريم أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم ربنا إنك جامع الناس ليوم لا ريب فيه إن الله لا يخلف الميعاد صدق الله العظيم. The ayah of the Quran that I have just recited to you come from a chapter, Surah Ali Imran. This is ayah number 9. In this ayah, there are three principles that are being talked about. It is a dua, but besides that, the very first word when we say Rabbana, that means we are saying dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so we consider Him our Rabb. That is part of our iman, that we believe in Him. On top of that, we have a hope, because He loves us, that there will be a day when we will need Him the most, and His mercy. And we are asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to save us on that day, when there will be no other savior but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we are saying in this dua, رَبَّنَا إِنَّكَ indeed. جَامِعُ النَّاسِ You will gather all the people that have ever come on the planet Earth. الْيَوْمِ On the day, لَا رَيْبَ فِيهِ I believe in it. I have no doubts in it that there will be a day of judgment. There will be a day of judgment on which you will be مَالِكِ يَوْمِ الدِّينِ You will be the king on that day. And O Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I also know that you have promised those who have believed in you the paradise. And I know, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُخْلِفُ الْمِعَادِ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not go back on His promises. So, the one who doesn't go back on His promises is the one who fulfills the promises. The one who fulfills the promises, that means he gave a word and he's living up to that word, is truthful. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who is the ultimate truth, is al-haq, the truth. The truth starts with Him, and the truth lies with Him all in all. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran to us, the believers, Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu, the moment you say La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, you have believed. So those of who you have believed, اتقوا Be God conscious. Whatever actions you do in your daily life, just remember at the back of your head that there is one day that you have to be answerable for these deeds. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, اتقوا من From who? اتقوا الله Be God conscious. When you're God conscious, you will do right thing. So don't be people conscious. Be God conscious. You will always make the right decision. وَكُونُوا And be ma'a with الصَّادِقِينَ The truthful. Now the beautiful thing is, that before Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam declared to the people of Makkah about his prophethood, even in those times, they would call him As-Sadiq, the truthful. So when there was the biggest dispute in the life of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam in the city of Makkah, before proclaiming prophethood, before declaring prophethood, was when the people were trying to put the black stone in the Kaaba after the Kaaba was rebuilt. They all these chiefs of different clans brought the bowls filled with animal blood, and they dipped their hands in it and took it out and said, "We will fight for it, that we should have the honor of putting this back." And then they decided, tomorrow morning the first person who walks in Kaaba will be the person who will going to be the judge among us. And when the next morning the sun rises, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam is the first person who walks in Kaaba, and they look at him and they say, "This is the truthful. We all agree on his judgment." And then when Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam declared the prophethood, the people started accepting Islam. The first free man who accepted Islam was Abu Bakr, who was given the title of As-Siddiq, the truthful, by the Prophet himself. So the truth is in the foundation. That is why when the Prophet entered the Makkah as a conqueror, and he was putting down all these false gods, because the true God is the one that needs to be worshipped, what is he reciting? جَاءَ الْحَقِّ وَزَحَقَ الْبَاطِلِ إِنَّ الْبَاطِلَ كَانَ زَهُوقًا. And the truth has come, and there is no place for the falsehood left. Indeed, there is no place for falsehood, because it is the truth that prevails all the time. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned the list of the chosen people, His friends, He says, وَمَنْ يُطْعِ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولِ, the one who will going to be obedient to Allah and His Messenger. وَمَنْ يُطْعِ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَ فَأُولَٰئِكَ مَعَ الَّذِينَ, he will be among what kind of people? أَنْعَمَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِمْ, these will be the people that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed. And what are their four categories? النَّبِيِّينَ, prophets. Second category, as-siddiqeen, the truthful. After that, ash-shuhada and as-salihin. But siddiqeen is a very, very high status. Being truthful is a very high status. That's why when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Maryam introduced Ibrahim alayhi salam, said, وَذْكُرْ فِي الْكِتَابِ إِبْرَاهِيمِ, mention in my book Ibrahim, إِنَّهُ كَانَ صِدِّيقًا نَبِيًّا, he was a truthful prophet. Then talked about Ismail alayhi salam in the same surah, few ayahs down, وَذْكُرْ فِي الْكِتَابِ إِسْمَعِيلِ, mention in my book Ismail alayhi salam, إِنَّهُ كَانَ صَادِقَ الْوَعْدِ, he would always live up to his promises. صَادِقَ الْوَعْدِ وَكَانَ رَسُولًا نَبِيًّا. Two ayahs down, talks about Idris alayhi salam, وَذْكُرْ فِي الْكِتَابِ إِدْرِيسِ, mention in my book the Prophet Idris, إِنَّهُ كَانَ صِدِّيقًا نَبِيًّا. So these are the prophets. These are from among the men. What about from among the women? Allah also talks about from among the women and says in Surah Ma'idah, ayah number 75, مَا الْمَسِيحُ بْنُ مَرْيَمَ إِلَّا رَسُولٌ, Jesus, the Messiah, the son of Mary, is a prophet of God. قَدْ خَلَتْ مِنْ قَبْلِهِ الرُّسُلِ, before him came many messengers and prophets. وَأُمُّهُ, and his mother, صِدِّيقَةٌ, truthful woman. Truthful woman. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions about the truth over and over and over in the Quran. Let's look at Yusuf alayhi salam. Two prisoners enter in the jail cell with him. Yusuf alayhi salam is wrongly accused. They look at his behavior and approach him to interpret dreams for them. He interprets the dreams. The outcomes are exactly like he says them, by the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And one of the man who is freed comes back to Yusuf alayhi salam with a question. And now see how the Quran introduces, how he addresses Yusuf alayhi salam. Yusufu ayyuhas siddiq. Yusuf, oh the truthful one. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned this as a good trait, as a good thing. And this is something that will help us in this life and hereafter. I'll bring you the hadith which is muttafaqun alayh, which is reported by both Imam Bukhari and Imam Muslim. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiyallahu ta'ala anhu narrates it from the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. And the Prophet said, إِنَّ الصِّدْقَ يَهْدِي إِلَى الْبِرِّ. The truthfulness will going to lead you to good things. وَإِنَّ الْبِرَّ يَهْدِي إِلَى الْجَنَّةِ. And the truthful things, the good things, will going to lead you into Jannah. وَإِنَّ الرَّجُلَ لَيَصْدُقُ حَتَّى يَكُونَ صِدِّيقًا. And the person starts saying the truth, and truth, and truth, until he reaches a point of truthfulness where the angels in the book write him down as As-Siddiq, the truthful. And the one who lies, وَإِنَّ الْكَذِبَ يَهْدِي إِلَى الْفُجُورِ. And the lies will take you to sins. وَإِنَّ الْفُجُورَ يَهْدِي إِلَى النَّارِ. And these sins will take a person into a hellfire. وَإِنَّ الرَّجُلَ لَيَكْذِبُ حَتَّى يُكْتَبَ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ كَذَّابًا. And the person who lies and lies and lies, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala writes him down as a liar. Think about it on the Day of Judgment. If a person is introduced as a truthful versus a person who is introduced as a liar, there's a huge difference. In another hadith reported by Imam Ahmad, very beautiful hadith, very strong hadith, Abdullah ibn Amr, the son of Amr ibn As, both father and son were the companions. In fact, the son accepted Islam before the father. Abdullah ibn Amr radiallahu ta'ala anhu reports that anna rajulan jaa ila an-nabi, a man came to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, faqala, he asked, ya Rasulullah, O Prophet of Allah, مَا عَمَلُ الْجَنَّةِ. What should I do that I may enter the Jannah? And the Prophet said, الصدق, be truthful. إِذَا صَدَقَ الْعَبْدُ بَرَّ. When the man is truthful, he's going towards the good things, the good deeds. وَإِذَا بَرَّ أَمِنَ. When he's truthful, that means he's staying away from lies, that means he's staying away from sins. وَإِذَا أَمِنَ دَخَلَ الْجَنَّةِ. And when he is saved from all of these bad things, that's exactly what will call upon the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help him enter the Jannah. And in the same hadith, it's a long hadith, the opposite has been talked about, that will going to take the people into the hell. Another hadith reported by Imam Tirmizi and Imam Nisa'i rahmah. And there's a portion of that hadith that I'm bringing you. فَإِنَّ الصِّدْقَ تَمَانِينَةٌ. The truthfulness brings peace at heart. Once you have peace at heart, you're happy, you're content, you're a good heart person, so you want to do good deeds. That's exactly what it is. وَالْكَذِبَ رِيبَةٌ. And the lies will going to make you doubtful. You're not going to be at ease and at peace. I'll share with you a story of two women that I read today in the news in New York. One is 80 years old, one is 70 years old, retired. The 80-year-old is a retired chemist, the 70-year-old is a retired psychoanalyst. They realize that there are so many poor people who have medical bills piling up, and they notice that there's an organization, Rest in Peace Medical Bills. So they collected over the last summer $12,500. To send it over to this organization. They open up a portfolio that for every half a penny to a dollar portfolio. And just recently they paid off 1,248 New Yorkers who could not afford to pay medical bills in $1.5 million. That's goodness. Good hearts can think like that. What do these two old women have to do? 70 years old, 80 years old, retired. Why do they have to do all this? Because of the goodness of the heart. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, be truthful and you will have this goodness of the heart. I would like to end today's khutbah with this ayah from Surah Al-Ahzab, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنَّ الْمُسْلِمِينَ وَالْمُسْلِمَاتِ وَالْمُؤْمِنِينَ وَالْمُؤْمِنَاتِ The Muslim men and the Muslim women, the believing men and the believing mu'min, وَالْقَانِتِينَ وَالْقَانِتَاتِ The obedient men and the obedient women, وَالصَّادِقِينَ وَالصَّادِقَاتِ The truthful men and the truthful women. So among the list of the good things, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is mentioning all of them. And towards the closing of the ayah says, أَعَدَّ اللَّهُ لَهُمْ مَغْفِرَةً These are the people for whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has prepared His forgiveness. وَأَجْرًا عَظِيمًا And a reward that is beyond your imagination. And that's exactly what we need. When Allah forgives, He sends to Jannah. When He gives high rewards, that elevates your place in Jannah. Subhanallah. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم